kids, today we are gonna make a simmering pot potpourri.
It's YouTube's best for creative things, it's cooking and crafting.
I got this little baby ninja. I guess it's, you know, for little dips or whatever to keep nice and warm. And let's face it, who's gonna wanna continue to replace things in there? So I thought that's not really worth it, you know, to have two cups at a time in there. So I thought, what can I do with this? And I decided what I was going to start doing is I'm going to start making my own little potpourri type simmering pots. And couple that with orange that has been sitting way too long to be eaten. I'm going to go ahead and use this. You can use just the rind. So what I'm going to do, since this is a really small pot, you can use your regular, you know, large sized slow cooker. I'm just opting to use this little simmering pot. I'm going to use only half of this orange and the other half I'm going to dry out the rind, I think. But basically I'll put in like the regular sized slow cooker recipe would basically be two oranges cut into pieces. And I've already put a little bit of water in here, and I'm gonna float these orange pieces in here. You can really combine anything that you really like, you know, the spices or flavors or whatever you really truly enjoy. This is a bit of cloves. It says to put in about a tablespoon, but since we're cutting down, we'll just put in a few. And some cinnamon sticks, if I can break them, because I'm kind of wimpy. Yeah, not gonna be able to do it. That one's really thick. This one isn't too bad. And then a little bit more of this, and then I'm gonna top it up again and make sure that this is covered with water. And basically what we're gonna do is we're just gonna let that sit all day long and simmer and let the spices take over the house. But what you need to do is to perhaps set your a timer for, say, every hour or so to double check and see if the, you know, water needs replenishing, because you don't want it to go dry. And you also do not want to leave this unattended, as in, you know, leaving your house and letting this sit burning unattended, okay? But there you go, one recipe for a simmering pot potpourri. I hope you do it, and I hope you enjoy. I came out to check it to make sure the water levels are okay, and because this is just a little warmer and not a real slow cooker, the scent is taking a little longer for it to spread. So probably more advisable to use a potpourri pot that you can buy at like Walmart or even your regular slow cooker. I added some ground cinnamon to it also, to give it a better flavor in there, and it did bump up the smell a bit when I did that.
Thank you for watching Cooking and Crafting.